Nuclear propulsion, Starship.com, Dragon and Starliner still in 2019, Orion at the launch pad, OmagA test fire that went very, very well, and results of a NASA study to commercialize low Earth orbit. My name is Felix, and I am your host for today's episode of What About It? There's loads of topics, so let's dive right in. Momentum grows for nuclear thermal propulsion. This is sci-fi in the making. The NASA Space Technology Program on Monday 22nd got a funding for thermonuclear propulsion and is working on the project right now. The goal is to have flight demonstration by 2024. But what about it? What is nuclear thermal propulsion and why should we care? And why didn't we use it up until now? The idea has been around for a long, long time now. Even the Apollo program considered the technology to get us to the moon. The idea is pretty simple. Use the process of nuclear fission to heat up hydrogen gas to a temperature of 2400 degrees. This heated gas then gets inserted into a nozzle and pushes the rocket forward. Nice and easy, right? And why wasn't it considered to be an option until now? Well, it's the good old radioactivity we're afraid of. And right so. What if the rocket explodes? The fallout would be spread everywhere if it happens at a higher altitude. Today, though, this picture has changed a little bit. In a stationary nuclear reactor, highly enriched uranium is used to fuel the fission process. It might be possible, though, to fuel nuclear thermal propulsion with low enriched uranium. That's far less dangerous. Also, the amount of uranium that is split in the process is actually quite small, about the size of a marble. Rocket efficiency is stated in seconds per specific impulse. For those of you who don't know what that is, this refers to the time in seconds that 1 pound of propellant will deliver 1 pound of thrust. The higher the seconds of specific impulse, the greater the propellant economy. SpaceX's Falcon 9 Merlin 1D engine, for example, has a specific impulse of 311 seconds. With NTP, we could possibly reach a specific impulse of up to 800 seconds. That would basically cut the travel time to Mars in half. That's great news. Shorter travel times mean less harm done to the astronauts by zero-G and radiation. Next up, SpaceX Starship teaser website appears ahead of June presentation, production ramps up on the prototypes of Starhopper, and Gwynne Shotwell states that it will fly within the next 18 months. Starship.com is life. What a cool domain name, by the way. You heard me. SpaceX has just turned on a new website to tease the upcoming Starship presentation by CEO Elon Musk on June 20th. Starship development continues at a breakneck pace. Right now, there are 3 prototypes being constructed at the Boca Chica facility and a recently revealed secret facility in Florida. Both teams are competing and constructing the ship in a different way to further speed up development. Who expected them to do it the usual way, right? On May 29th, Gwynne Shotwell talked at MIT about launching our future. There she mentioned that we should expect to see Starship to fly into orbit within the next 18 months, and that in the same time span that NASA is trying to get somebody back to the moon, we should expect Starship to deliver cargo to Mars. Until 2024. Fun fact, Elon still says 2022 for the cargo mission. Who do we trust more? NASA suggests 2019 launch date for SpaceX Crew Dragon mission still possible, and Boeing Starliner avoids delay ahead of demo mission. According to NASA, the first crewed mission of a Dragon capsule to the ISS might still be possible in 2019. On April 20th, the unthinkable happened. In a normal abort thrust test, Crew Dragon spit fire and exploded in a so-called anomaly. This brought the whole mission to a grinding halt. If the capsule is not completely secure, you can't send astronauts to space with it. Since then, SpaceX and NASA worked together to find the cause of this fiery incident. The capsule that exploded was the one that flew on the Demo 1 mission back in March. It already proved its capabilities and should have flown again on the in-flight abort mission this summer. Why, oh why, did you do this? With the capsule lost, SpaceX will have to use the capsule originally planned for the Crew 1 mission. This leaves us with one missing capsule. SpaceX is working hard on solving this problem. And Kathy Luders, manager of the Commercial Crew Program at NASA, said on May 28th that SpaceX is trying to get it done until the end of the year. At ULA, the race has begun. There's a title to be won, and with Dragon spitting fire, they're back in the race more than ever. But what about it? Boeing CST-100 Starliner, the big competitor, is getting ready for its first flight to the ISS. The uncrewed orbital flight test is scheduled for August, with the in-flight abort test to follow soon after. Eager to present results and show their progress, Tory Bruno, the CEO of United Launch Alliance, has tweeted a picture of the Atlas V rocket that will carry the first Starliner into orbit. This would be the first time that ULA has no delay in their Starliner program. If they manage to pull this off, a very important trophy will be taken away from SpaceX. Because who talks about the second team to achieve something, right? NASA Orion AA2 vehicle at the launch pad for July test. Orion is on the move again. In the night of May 22nd to 23rd, the test capsule of Orion was rolled out to meet its booster at Launch Complex 46. The SR-118 booster, formerly intended for the 2002 cancelled ICBM Peacekeeper program, has been sitting there, waiting for Orion, since April. NASA's Orion spacecraft is built to take humans farther than they've ever gone before. Orion will serve as the exploration vehicle that will carry the crew to space, provide emergency abort capabilities, sustain the crew during the space travel, and provide safe re-entry from deep space return velocities. Orion will launch on NASA's new heavy lift rocket, the Space Launch System. There's so much going on in spaceflight right now. Incredible! Northrop Grumman test fires new heavy lift OmagA rocket stage for the first time, and everything goes very, very well. On Thursday, May 30th, Northrop Grumman conducted a full-scale static fire test of the first stage of their OmagA rocket. The rocket, intended for national security launches, is scheduled for its first test flight in 2021. As stated after the test by Ken Drumminger, OmagA vice president at Northrop Grumman, everything went very, very well. The rocket fired for 122 seconds as intended and... wait, what? Let's rewind that again. What was that? According to Ken, that was nothing, even though half the nozzle exploded. Just a normal test. Nope, nothing to see here. Let's continue with the last topic, shall we? NASA releases results of study to commercialize low Earth orbit. But what about it? On May 28th, NASA released the results of a very interesting study. Back in August of last year, NASA selected 13 companies to conduct studies on the potential of commercial human spaceflight in low Earth orbit. Blue Origin's team, with their out-of-the-box thinking at reusing a spent upper stage of the New Glenn rocket as a habitat, was able to surprise. Others like Northrop Grumman or Boeing submitted their results as well. From the commercialization of the ISS to more traditional approaches of building habitats, everything can be found in the results. I'll put a link in the description for you. It's more than interesting. So this wraps up today's episode of What About It? What do you think? Is nuclear thermal propulsion a viable shortcut to Mars? What will we see at the Starship presentation in June? Who's right about the first cargo flight to Mars, Gwynny or Elon? And did the OmagA static fire test really go very, very well? What do you think, Kent? And will the upper stage of a New Glenn rocket be cozy inside? Tell me in the comments, I'm eager to know. Thank you for watching this episode of What About It? If you liked what you saw, don't forget to press the like button and subscribe to the channel, because that helps a lot. Also, hit me up on my Patreon page to give me additional help in creating more and better content, because that's what I like to do the most, to give you the latest and greatest in space and science. I hope to see you on the next episode. Until then, have a great time.
T plus 120 seconds.